I'm going to show you how to use AI to improve your PowerPoint slides. So, how do you do that? I'm going to use two AI tools, ChatGPT and GammaApp. But before I do this demonstration, I just want to let you know that now you can have a desktop version of ChatGPT. I'll be putting the link there so that you can download the desktop version. So when you go to the OpenAI website, they have an article that talks about using ChatGPT Windows app, and it gives you information about how to download. The interface is quite similar to the one that is online. So what you have to do is that when you go to this article, there's a link here, which is the Microsoft Store. You can click on that link, and then it will take you to Microsoft Store, and then you can download this one. And when you download, you have a version like what I have here. This is the desktop version, right? So that you don't have to go to the website again. If you want to use ChatGPT, you can just click on the app on your desktop or on your computer, and you'll be able to get access to ChatGPT. So this is an update that I just want to give to you before I go to the main presentation. So let's go. I made its presentation, but I just want to improve upon it a little bit. I want the slide to look better than what I have here. So what I'm going to do first is to go to ChatGPT. And then when you go to ChatGPT, make sure that you have the paid version. If you don't have the paid version, you don't have the option that I'm going to show you. So if you have the paid version, you click here and it gives you all the options. If you can go to GPT-4o with Canvas, that's what we're going to use. Because what we want to do is that we're going to let AI develop an article based on the PowerPoint, and then we take the article to Gamma to be able to develop a new PowerPoint for us. So let's go to this option. So we click on the Canvas option and you attach the PowerPoint. And this is what you're going to write. You can say, can you create an article based on the attached PowerPoint slides? So when you click on enter, this is what happened. A new interface will be shown to you. So you can see here that it's showing here about the article, and this one is telling you what exactly it did, right? So now you have the article here. This one is so interesting because it's so good and exciting too, because now you can review the article and make sure that everything is right. You can edit the article, and there are some options here for you. You can click here. If, let's say, the length is short for you, what you can do is that you can click here and go to adjust the length, and you can make the length longer, or you can make it shorter if it's long. So let's make the length a little bit longer, and then you can click on that, and ChatGPT will go through and make the article longer. It has made the content 50% longer, right? As you can see here. The reading level. This one depends on who you want to send this article to, right? In our case, we want to use this article to generate a new PowerPoint, right? And also, you can think about who is going to receive this information or who are you going to present the information to. If it's college level or graduate level, you can indicate that then the system will go through and improve the document so that it will meet the needs of your audience. If you want to present it to middle school students, yes, you can always indicate that. So let's assume that you want to present it to graduate students, right? So you move it to graduate school and then you click on it, and then it will go through the article again and make some adjustments so that to reflect the command that you have given. Another interesting thing is that you can also edit. Now, if you want to make some changes to what has been written, you can say add final polish, right? You can click here and click on it again. This is where the system will go through the article again and make improvements. Let's say there's a problem with the sentence structure or the flow of the information, the system will be able to do that for you. Another thing that you can do is that, let's say you want to make a little adjustment to this paragraph, you can give a command. Can you provide a comprehensive example, and then click on enter. It will make adjustment to only this paragraph. Now, if you want to see what changes has happened, There should be something there where we can go to the previous version, right? So if you want to see the previous version, you can click here and it will show you the previous version. For the website version of ChatGPT, you have this additional icon showing it says show changes, right? When you go to the desktop version, it doesn't have that option. So you can click on that and you show what the system has done. The red one is the ones that have been eliminated, and the green ones was the new information that has been added to the article, right? So this icon, if you want to use it, you always have to use the web-based ChatGPT and not the desktop version, because desktop version doesn't have that option there. Maybe in the near future they will bring that option, but they don't have it. So you just bear in mind that if you want to use this function, you always have to use the web-based version of ChatGPT. If you are satisfied with the article the system has created for you, you can click here to copy, right? And you can copy it and put it on a Word document, or you can just go to, in this case, I want to develop a PowerPoint based on this information, right? So I'll go to gamma.app and then I click on Create New. So I go to paste in text and I paste the article here. See the article that I got from ChatGPT. You can choose whether you want it as a presentation form like a PowerPoint, or you want it to be like a web page, or you want it as a document, a PDF. We want it as a PowerPoint. So we choose the first one. You click on continue. And here you have a choice. You can allow the system to generate the PowerPoint, but informed by this article, or you want it to generate information in a condensed manner, right? But if you want to really preserve all the information that has been presented here, then you can check on preserve, right? Especially if you don't want AI to add more information to what you have here. I choose condense and then I choose brief. So because it's a PowerPoint, you don't want to give you detailed information on the PowerPoint, you want a brief information there as you are presenting. The cards are the number of slides, right? So here I can make it up to 15 slides. If you want to make more, you have to upgrade. I made it 15 and go to continue. This one, you can have a choice to choose from the theme that we have here, the design, how they want the colors to be like, right? So in this case, I'll choose this design. If you don't want, you can always change. So let me see which one I would like better. I think, yeah, I like this one. Let me see. Yeah, it looks good, right? This is a preview for you to see how the design will look like. When you are done, we click on generate, and then the system generate the information for you. The good thing is that you can always edit and change the pictures if you want to. Option for you to edit. You can take out the name. This one, if you want to take your name out, you can do that. You always can edit in the system, or you can download and then you can edit it on the PowerPoint slide. So this is what you have been given. And if you are now okay with what you have, it looks very good and nice. You can click here to present if you want to do the presentation on the Gamma app. When you are done, you can exit. And if you want to download, you click on share. And you have an option here, export. You can export it as PDF, you can export it as PowerPoint or PNGs. So we want it as PowerPoint. So we click on that. And then it will export or download that information. And as I said, when you finish downloading, you can always edit the slides and add more slides if you want to. So you see how we have it nice here, and you see how it's better than the old version. It's improved. I like the diagrams there, and I like the pictures also there. So this is what I have for you. If you have any question, please let me know. I'll put the link for Gamma in the description section so that you'll be able to access this app, please subscribe to my channel and I'll be happy to share and do more videos to help you to understand how to use all these AI tools to help you to do your research. Thank you for your time.